Good morning, class. Today we will take up the topic learning as part of the subject organizational behavior. We will understand the meaning and definition of learning, the nature of learning, and some learning theories such as classical conditioning theory and operant conditioning theory. So let's start. Learning can be defined as a change in behavior acquired through experience. This simply means that learning is a modification in one's behavior. It is a change that we observe in somebody's behavior. However, the change must be not a temporary one and should be a result of some practice or experience. Let us understand it further with the help of an example. Supposingly, a student comes late in his lecture for the very first time. However, this could happen as a mere incident due to some traffic congestion, etc. It could happen that the next day A comes to the class in time. Now this could not be said as learning that A has acquired, because the change was temporary, that is for only one day. However, let's assume that A comes late to the class today and continues this for another 5 days. This means that A has now acquired a habit of coming late to the class, which was a result of the practice of coming late on a regular basis. Now we could say that A has learned a new behavior, that is of coming late to his class. Now let us understand a definition. According to Robbins, learning is any relatively permanent change in behavior that occurs as a result of experience. Moving further, let's have a look at some of the characteristics of learning. Point number one, it involves a change in behavior. As said earlier, learning means any change that we notice in someone's behavior. So this is the first characteristic of learning. Second, the change must be relatively permanent. This has been explained by way of an example of Mr. A. If a change is only for a short duration of time, that is temporary, it cannot be regarded as learning. Changes that are for longer duration of time or are permanent are classified as learning. Next, the change must be based on practice. Practice means repeating an action over and over again. Actions which are repeated or practiced on a continuous basis result in some form of learning. And next is, learning is a lifelong process. It continues throughout one's life. Now, moving forward, let's understand some learning theories. One of the important learning theories is the classical conditioning theory. This theory was developed by Ivan Pavlov. Pavlov conducted some experiments on a dog. That is, he wanted to know how conditioning happens in animals. What Pavlov did was, he presented a piece of flesh to the dog, and he observed that the dog started to salivate. Next, what he did was, he simply rang a bell, and he noticed that the dog did not respond to the ringing of the bell. The next day, Pavlov combined the ringing of the bell and flesh or meat together. What he did was, he used to ring the bell and present meat to the dog simultaneously. As a result, he did this for many days, and as a result, he observed that the dog started to salivate. At last, what happened was, when Pavlov simply rang the bell, the dog used to salivate. That is, the dog had learned to salivate to the mere ringing of the bell. So this is an example of classical conditioning. Now let's understand another theory, that is operant conditioning theory. This theory was given by Skinner. Now Skinner was of the view that learning happens as a result of consequences. That is, employees or people, they learn only those behaviors which they think could be rewarding to them. And people or employees avoided those behaviors which they thought could result in some form of punishment to them. That is to say, learning is related to consequences. This theory is based on the law of effect, which states that behavior that has a rewarding consequence is to be repeated, whereas behavior that leads to punishment tends not to be repeated. In organizations, it could be seen that the frequency of various behaviors happen as a consequence or result that is associated with behaviors. That is why Skinner believed that in order to motivate employees, organizations should reward performances, that is, people or employees who performed to the best of the ability should be rewarded, as it will encourage the employees to further practice the same kind of behavior, that is, working to the best of their ability. To sum up, we could say that human behavior is a function of its consequences. People learn to behave so that they may get something they want or avoid something that they do not want. So this was the operant conditioning theory of learning. So that was the topic for today. Thank you.